morning. You're watching Left, Right and Center. It's Friday night. We are just 1 week away from the results of the general election. On the show tonight, the Congress now attacks Narendra Modi over his caste, says he manipulated his OBC status for political gain. The BJP has hit back. But is this a justified attack by the Congress or is it a desperate strategy? Also, Mayawati and Mamata Banerjee have said no today to an alliance with a Modi-led NDA. But can Narendra Modi still win them over after the polls, or are the doors shut, as the two ladies say? But first, in the last stretch of this long, long election campaign, the Congress has decided to go after Narendra Modi over his caste, accusing him of faking his OBC status and adding his caste to the OBC list after he became Chief Minister in 2002. However, the BJP hit back, showing a state government notification from 1994 in which the caste was added to the OBC list. They've called the Congress move desperate.
NDA's Prime Ministerial candidate Narendra Modi pushing his OBC roots to woo voters. But now the Congress has hit back, claiming Modi was faking his humble origins as he wasn't born in a backward class community. They allege it was only in 2002, once Modi became Chief Minister, that his government included the Mod Ghanchi community, to which Modi belongs, in the OBC list.
Modi, jab paida hue tab, या बड़े हुए तब कभी भी पिछड़ी जाति में नहीं थे. अपर कास्ट तो है ही, पर उसमें भी ज्यादा पैसे वाले जो परिवार थे उसमें से आते थे.
The BJP, which sees Modi's humble origins as a tea seller, slammed the Congress, came up with the 1994 Gujarat government notification when Congress leader Chabildas Mehta was the Chief Minister. The notification shows that Mod Ghanchis were included in the OBC list as per the Mandal Commission's recommendations.
The Congress party is completely out of its depth. It makes Modi's humble origin as a tea vendor into a political issue.
Congress kyun pareshan hai itni zyada Modi ji ki jati ko lekar?
Is tarah ke muddon pe jaane ke bajaye ye bataye ki mehngai kyun badi, corruption kyun hua?
Pradhan Mantri ke umidwar hain. आज वो कास्ट कार्ड खेल रहे हैं. ये बार बार मोदी जी का कहना कि मैं नीच जाति से हूँ, पिछड़े वर्ग से हूँ, ये साबित करता है कि वो कहीं ना कहीं अपने को कमजोर महसूस कर रहे हैं.
कास्ट कार्ड हैज बीन रूथलेसली इन्वोक्ड बाय ऑलमोस्ट ऑल पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज इन द 2014 इलेक्शंस. नरेंद्र मोदी हैड टेकन स्वाइप एट प्रियंका गांधी आफ्टर हर नीच राजनीति कमेंट एंड रैली आफ्टर रैली ही इज बीन रेजिंग हिज हम्बल ओबीसी बैकग्राउंड. The Congress perhaps trying to negate that caste advantage by raising questions over his OBC status. In Ahmedabad, Rohit Ban for NDTV.
So is this a justified attack by the Congress or is this a desperate strategy? This is an election in which everything seems to have been invoked, including all kinds of absurdities as well. But is this absurd or is this something that's much more serious? I'll take that question first to Sanjay Jha, the spokesperson of the Congress, who joins us from Mumbai. Sanjay, yesterday your colleague in the party, Shakti Singh Goyal, claimed that the Chief Minister of Gujarat, Mr. Modi, got his caste added to the OBC list after he became Chief Minister of Gujarat. The BJP has countered that with a 1994 state government notification in which there was a Congress Chief Minister, showing that that was when the OBC list was changed, long before Mr. Modi held any post. What is the party's official reaction to that?
Nidhi, let me tell you that the context needs to be understood. Mr. Modi has had an extraordinary ability, and you know he's got a gift of God that he can lie with remarkable confidence. And I bring the context here to the fact of the way he twisted Priyanka Gandhi's statement of Neech Rajniti, and the next day he went to town in Uttar Pradesh, actually appearing to be a very demoralized, devastated victim of casteism in India. Now, the truth of what Shakti Singh Gohil has really exposed, which despite the BJP challenge stands to be completely correct, is the fact that Mr. Modi, when he became the Chief Minister, they issued through a government notification or a resolution whereby the Mod Ghanchis were made into an OBC. Now, I'll answer you what the BJP is saying. The BJP is saying that in 1993, there was a notification done by the state government. The origin is actually the Mandal Commission. But the Mandal Commission had notified the Ghanchi Muslims. And let me repeat that again. The Ghanchi Muslims as an OBC category, not the Mod Ghanchis, who were actually supposed to be more prosperous and affluent. So In short, Mr. Modi has become an OBC as per government notification in the year 2002, which makes him till the age of 52 or whatever it is, a regular person without any caste issues, and therefore exposes the brazen lie that he actually tried to create for to the public of India at large, that he's been, you know, he's a victim
but
of
Sanjay,
some kind of casteism in India, which is totally untrue.
The 1994 notification clearly says that the Mohit Ghanchi caste was added as an OBC on the 25th of July 1994 and then by the central government on the 4th of April 2000. There's no mention of Muslims here.
Well, let me tell you, that truly is the fact that actually appeared, and this is as per the central government notification. Now, as far as the issue is concerned, and this is what Shakti Singh Gohil actually explained yesterday in the press conference, that there are Ghanchi Muslims and there are Mohit Ghanchis. Now, you know, we can get into the technicalities of it, but the truth is, if you look at the government notification
which is
of
why
2002,
I'm pointing out what the notification
no,
says.
One minute. No, Nidhi, why would, let me ask you a question. Why would the state government on January 1, 2002 pass a notification if it was already done earlier? I mean, that's the question that we need to answer.
Okay, let me
because
take that
because it
to
wasn't done earlier. And
are
the
there
truth
two
is that the OBC
are
state
separate
has come
state
into effect only after
then?
That.
No, there are not two separate notifications. The notifications, the Social Welfare Department of the Gujarat government, dated July 25, 1994, and serial number 25(6), is Mohit Ghanchi caste being clearly mentioned.
That's what I read out.
The Congress has made a big bloomer. They have made many bloomers in this campaign, and they don't have the grace to accept that they've made a mistake. They go and go on lying till they're blue in the face. But the fact of the matter is that this is the notification. There's no notification of 2002, nor has the Congress produced any such notification.
So they've made a mistake, and why do you think they've
mistake?
Done that?
Mistake? It's a blunder.
Can I answer that?
It's a bloomer and a blunder.
Can I answer that?
Yes. Sanjay Jha, I mean, you know, is Mr. Modi's caste now at the fag end of the campaign really an issue? The question is, this was meant to be an election about development, and it's in the last couple of phases in particular become about everything else but that.
You know, but that's exactly what I said, Nidhi. I'll give you examples after example. I mean, the reason why this is an issue is because of the fact that he made it into an issue. And therefore, it had to be absolutely exposed. And the reason why it's taken longer to come out, and Shakti Singh Gohil had clarified, is he had applied for an RTI application. He got the response only a few days ago. But the pertinent point, Mr. Modi's marital status, of which there's been a lot of debate, wasn't known till just a few weeks ago. Why? I mean, these are questions that people need to know. And I'll give you another example. When he went to town about the Pink Revolution, he never told the public of India, and I have facts on with detailed circulars here, which tell you that actually the cow slaughterhouses and meat production in Gujarat doubled during the time of Mr. Modi over 10 years.
Okay, no, I,
so, you know,
I just want to stick to the issue of caste. I want to ask Mr. Swami, though, one second. On the point that you made, which is actually true, it is that Mr. Modi himself has invoked his caste. Of course, after Priyanka's attack, but he's been talking about it again and again. He's tweeted about it today. He's spoken about it today again. And that, largely political analysts feel, is because of these two phases that we're now voting, where the OBC status is going to be an important card to play. It's a political
No, you see, the question is, Priyanka Vadra did
can
use
I come
the
in
word.
Nidhi Razdan, this
one
has
moment,
a lot
sir. One moment,
context.
Sir. Let me just get an answer from Mr. Swami.
Priyanka Vadra did use the word niche. Neech Bhasha or whatever. Now, when Amit Shah said Badla Lena hai, button daba karke Mulayam Singh Sarkar ko harana ke liye, that Badla was interpreted to mean that an attack on the Muslims. Now, when you say Neech, it's there is a pejorative sense there, and Modi said, is this what they are saying? And he made it an issue.
But he's playing the caste card again.
Now, wait a minute. Now, for them to go one step forward to say he's not backward class, and that was to also turned out to be either a lie or a bloomer, or their typical ignorance that we see in Congress campaigns. And consequently, he has got a clear reason now to go on this issue. If after that niche comment and the rebuttal, the matter had rested there, it would have been over. Now this OBC thing is such a big bloomer. How can Modi miss it?
But Mr. Bhadauria, Mayawati has been very, very critical of Mr. Modi on this issue as well. Is it because she is nervous about him playing the OBC card in her, on her turf?
Let me put the record straight and let me also state this, that Mr. Modi is nervous today because he started his campaign on development and has finally come out in his true colors. And let me also explain this whole caste business that we are debating over here. And we have to go a little backwards to understand where this whole debate emanates from. Mr. Swamy will remember that the Mandal Commission was set up in 1977, and 1989, when Mr. V.P. Singh was the Prime Minister, the Mandal Commission was made into a law, and it was then that the BJP of that time withdrew the support from the government of V.P. Singh because they started the Ram Yatra agitation, and Mr. Swamy was also not with them, though he was with Chandrasekhar ji at that time. He will remember that the V.P. Singh's government was the supports was withdrawn and the government was brought down. And now today, at that time, when the Ram Mandir agitation was on, Mr. Modi himself was against the Mandal agitation. He was against those people who were being given reservation on the basis of the OBC status. And it was probably because he was not part of the OBC. This caste system is thousands of years of old caste system. It has not emerged now in 1990. They have been, Mr. Modi has been part of a social system which has been part of the ruling elite in this country. He has not been part of the oppressed, subjugated and exploited sections of Indian society, which Behen Mayawati ji has reiterated, which you find in the writings of Mahatma Phule and Baba Saab Bhimrao Ambedkar's book, Annihilation of Caste System. Okay. So therefore, today to claim our OBC status is trying to fool the people of this country, but the people of the country understand all his game, and that is why today in his nervousness, yesterday in his interview, he says he wants support from all and none is giving to willing to give him support.
So who's nervous here? The Congress and the BSP say it's Mr. Modi who's nervous, so he's resorting to the caste card. And, you know, the BJP saying it's the Congress that's nervous, which is why it's launching this kind of an attack.
This is an incredible discussion. I cannot believe I'm part of it. I mean, here, neither can you. Because here, this has come out. Let us say Modi brought the Mod Ghanchi into the OBC list in 2000. Listen, as far as I know, we are in 2014. Couldn't they have gone to court for such a huge injustice that you've got undeserving people into the OBC? Then the second thing, I cannot believe it. This campaign has been on for at least 10 months. Let's say out of that, about 4 months or 5 months, we've heard of the OBC status of Mr. Modi. We've done 8 phases of this campaign. Now on the 9th phase, you have brought this out and you're saying that he's not an OBC. And the last thing I think, let us say that Modi did this in 2000 or 2001. After becoming chief minister, now are we, or is the Congress party, and are the all parties, are they not distinguishing between polity and politics? Politics is only one part of the polity. Now a chief minister, if he thinks this is right, he will do it. This is within his, what is called in Hindi, adhikar kshetra, his rights. Now today you have got jats who are OBCs in some states and not in other states. You've got Meenas.
But isn't
who are
it true
OBCs.
That Mr. Modi himself exploited the OBC
no,
card?
We were talking about Priyanka's comments the other day.
You know that they could have meant anything.
One small thing. Yes, they could have meant anything. I can totally agree with you. But one small thing. In 2000 or 2001, that Narendra Modi knew that he was going to be the prime ministerial candidate of the Bharatiya Janata Party in 2014 really stretches any imagination and any belief. I think that today, such a construct, which was a feudal construct, which was done in agrarian times, this whole caste business, which was for manpower and money power. You went to your caste because these two things you couldn't get from any other place. That it has unfortunately stayed with us, because today people still feel that they cannot get it. So these alliances, we are talking about that today. It is incredible. I cannot even pinch myself to say I'm part of this discussion in the 21st or 22nd century of India.
I'm still pinching.
Both Ghanji and Ghanji.
Well, one second. But Subramanian Swamy,
Mr.
you have to concede
Modi
the point.
Modi himself has been over and over stating, at least in each meeting, he has been saying 14
Nidhi,
times, 15
no,
times.
That is what I'm saying. That
went
to court. One second, Sanjay.
He has himself invoked the value of caste.
Kindly
he is
go to
the
court.
One who is responsible for this
that
whole
is the
debate.
Point. Exactly. And the point is, Mr. Swamy, okay, so she talks about Neech Rajneeti. Now, that has been interpreted in a certain way, which many feel was a bit of a stretch by Mr. Modi. I mean, they said they were talking about low-level politics.
No, Congress can't complain. They did it with Amit Shah. He said badla.
No, so,
and
so
you,
Modi
you
twisted it, to his convenience.
Invoking a communal riot.
No, so Modi used it to his convenience, politically.
Well, in politics, when you see an opportunity, you're not going to miss it. There's nothing that he's done wrong which is not according to the rules by which the Congress was playing.
It's an opportunity, political opportunity.
Of course, it's an opportunity.
So you're
after,
honest about that.
Only that opportunity would have been illegitimate if the Congress had not made a misuse of the word badla and dragged Amit Shah to the election commission and so on. So therefore,
so all's
now,
fair in love, war and politics.
Well, we are in politics.
Pretty
if you
much.
Give me an opportunity, I will use it. There's no question about it.
No, so Subramanian Swamy admits that.
And the fact of the matter is that this comes in a long list of things like calling us rats and donkeys, so many other things. Now, he is only saying, I'm OBC, that's all. He's not abusing anybody.
No, so Sanjay Jha, Subramanian Swamy admits that they took an opportunity, they saw an opportunity, and they've taken it. All's fair in politics.
You know, Nidhi, I think that's so totally incorrect. I mean, are we once again ridiculing the Election Commission? Who decided to ban Mr. Amit Shah's hate speech? It was the Election Commission. Now, we may have complained. But because there was merit
just
in the complaint,
small point,
and
maybe.
It is not just about the, you know, the ballot box. I mean, you know, if you look at the various speeches that Mr. Amit Shah made, revenge had a very, very clear-cut tenor. I mean, it was said in Muzaffarnagar, for heaven's sake. And we all know the role that BJP had in the Muzaffarnagar riots, where they had three of their MLAs booked who are fighting the Lok Sabha election. So I think there is a bigger political context here. And the second point, just to answer to Nalini Singh, that, you know, this is, you know, what we need to accept is the fact that Mr. Modi has played the caste card in a very orchestrated manner. The point that we need to discuss, and it is relevant that we need to discuss it, is because when an individual who is aspiring to be the Prime Minister is actually confessing that till the age of 52, he was like you and me and had no OBC status to cover him, but he suddenly wakes up, twists Priyanka Gandhi's speech,
nonsense.
And
That's
begins to play
nonsense.
To the gallery, then I think there are serious political motivations.
No, I think Mr. Sanjay,
and they're unethical, they're immoral.
No, no, but he's taken a comment and now he's talking about his caste in the final two phases of polling. You don't see a coincidence between the regions that are voting and his invoking the caste card.
I see political opportunism the same way as I saw it in that comment of honeymoon by Baba Ramdev, who does not understand the meaning of honeymoon, and therefore the Congress and other parties ran away with it, fair enough. So now if he's running away with
I think Baba Ramdev, I do not know Baba Ramdev by the way, but I think he probably does not know the implication of the word honeymoon.
Yes, I know the BSP will talk about it, but I just want to say that today I think that these are, to me, they demonstrate the decay in the core of our politics. If we are only talking about these issues, then there is a really decay at the core.
Well, look,
and
caste
I
politics
see
still exists. Jokes apart, the fact is it's still there.
It's still there, and it's decay.
And across parties, and these are factors in elections, whether we like them or not, even in 2014.
Yeah, I would say we have to move on.
Quickly, and then Sudhindra Baroya.
It is a hard reality at the ground level.
Yeah. Sentence, Nidhi, please.
Okay, Mr. Baroya. Give me one second.
Mrs. Indira Gandhi used to say
these people are now saying that the fact that these people are not now saying, I'm shocked to listen that Baba Ramdev's word of honeymoon with Dalit women is to be treated lightly. I think after what happened in Nirbhaya case and what
Mr. Madhuriya, I will not let you get away with getting
thing.
Me wrong.
But
no.
Let me also say one more thing. Mr. Modi has lost all conviction in everything. It is therefore he said in his interview just yesterday evening, he said that I have no qualms of having understanding with anybody. I have no conviction. This tutu meme is already is there in the election. Now I am a power hungry person. Let me please get the political power, however it may come, with whatever compromises it should come, but it should come to me.
Fine. But you cannot impute things to me. Certainly not. I won't
take it. May I say that, you see, when you, Modi is a backward class person and from a very poor family, after all, he was selling tea in a railway station. So you can't say that he was a rich baniya living in a palace. The fact of the matter is that in election campaigns, we have seen Mrs. Indira Gandhi saying, "Main dubla patli ek aurat hoon, aur mere piche ye sare mard pade hue hain." You know, the entire Morarji Desai, Nijling of Power, all portrayed as men who were trying to beat up a woman. Now, they were nothing of the kind, but she evoked it. In an election campaign, when you give such an opening, how can you say that Priyanka didn't mean this and Priyanka meant that? We know that she has used the word rats. Now, then she's constantly abusing, saying all kinds of things. Then you see she says Neech. So obviously he is taken
up. Would you concede the fact that these two phases, which are polling, have a large OBC backward caste population, that has obviously been factored in by Mr. Modi when he invokes the caste card?
No, he doesn't need that.
You've been blunt until now.
He doesn't need backward caste.
Why shift from the development agenda?
He's got a mass appeal. He went in yesterday in Varanasi last night without any announcement. What a turnout there was. It was even bigger than when
he wasn't talking about his caste.
Exactly. Yes. No. He, because this he said in the context of Miss Priyanka Vadra has said.
He had to
pick on that because he wants to show that this is what she meant.
But Mr. Swami, I think there's a lot of grain of truth in what Nidhi is saying, that actually this was not mentioned earlier. Caste is now being mentioned because in your 8th and 9th round, you
he's
have
not
people
invoking
with
caste. He's talking about how he is being picked on because he happens to be from backward class. Now they're saying he's not from backward class. That is a blatant lie.
And coincidentally, when so many
it's
OBCs
a blatant lie that he's not from the backward class.
Coincidentally, when so many OBCs will be voting. Okay, last quick words on this, Sanjay Jha. Yes.
Yeah, you know, Nidhi, if Mr. Modi genuinely felt excruciating pain for the disadvantaged classes in India, asking why did he not condemn Baba Ramdev's extremely disgusting and derogatory reference to Dalits when he made that honeymoon statement? I mean, he kept quiet. I heard BJP spokespeople actually endorsing what Baba Ramdev said. That just goes to tell the people of India how cosmetic this whole OBC exercise is. And it stands exposed today, no matter what the BJP tries to unearth as documents. And I think the second pertinent point is that Mr. Modi has now created a laundry list of, you know, bloomers and blunders, to borrow my BJP spokesperson's terms, that, you know, now it's the situation, his credibility is so low that at this point of time when he's questioned, I mean, everybody will believe it because of the simple reason that he's actually, you know, made a laundry list of classic faux pas, and I think they have exposed him that most unbecoming of a leader of a party.
Because there is a 1994 notification on his OBC status. That comes back to my original question, and of course you continue to dispute that, but anyway, we've seen the notification and there is nothing more I can say on that. I'm going to take a break. All of you are going to stay with us. I'll be back in 1 minute because we're going to talk about certain issues that actually Mr. Bhadauria also raised, the question of post-poll alliances. Today we've heard Mamta attacking Mr. Modi again. She's ruled out an alliance with the NDA post May 16th. So has Mayawati. But can Mr. Modi still win them over? That's in 1 minute.